Many thanks for joining us on the newsroom. President Muhammadu Buhari has met with the governor of his home state, Aminu Masari of Katsina, over growing reports of banditry in the region. The agenda of the meeting, which held at the presidential villa in Abuja, is yet to be made public, but it is expected that the issue of banditry and insurgency in the northwest will be addressed during the meeting. The Deputy Speaker of the Edo State House of Assembly, Yekini Diaye, has been impeached. He was impeached on Wednesday during a plenary session of the Assembly in Benin City, the state capital. His impeachment comes days after he and four others declared support for Osage Ezeyamu, who is contesting against incumbent Governor Godwin Obaseki in the coming September 10 governorship election. Meanwhile, Roland Asoro, representing Ohiongwa's 2 constituency, has been elected as the new Deputy Speaker of the House. Well, as part of measures to reduce financial pressure on residents, the Lagos State Government says it has reviewed the 2018 land use charge. The State Finance Commissioner, Rabi Oluwo, who confirmed the development, explained that in 2018, there was an increase in land use charge rate as well as the method of valuation of property. He said this shock had a sporadic increase in land use charge payable by property owners. According to him, the government has now decided to review the land use charge law by reversing the rates of land use charge to pre-2018, while upholding the 2018 method of valuation. The Abuja Police says it has released 62 persons who were arrested earlier today during the Revolution Now protest in the Federal Capital Territory. Following their arrest, the protesters were charged with violating COVID-19 guidelines. They were dispersed from the Unity Fountain and Eagle Square. Meanwhile, the Lagos State Police have arrested no fewer than 20 persons who took part in the protest in Lagos State. One of the detained protesters is journalist Agba Jalingo. A section of the Secretariat of the Economic Community of West African States, ECOWAS, in Asokoro, Abuja, has been gutted by fire. The inferno affected one of the floors housing the Finance and Accounts Department of the Secretariat. Officials from the fire service, who arrived the same minute after the inferno began, have managed to put out the flames. Meanwhile, investigations is ongoing to unravel the true cause of the fire. Let's take a break here to bring you more updates. Don't go away.
Now, believe this corruption. You know, if you touch black man, if you like, gather the whole Niger, come together, make a cough. Nothing.
Which one you want?
Give me V&D.
I beg, get small pieces.
How much you want to give him?
Give me 200. Take your change now, will
you? You don't want your change.
My people, this coronavirus, now serious matter, may we now wash your hands regularly. Come use alcohol-based hand sanitizer. If you no see water, wash your hand. Oh, make una sit down for house. You see this virus, so e no get leg. Now we dey waka kuru kere. No waka around, make the virus for die. No forget say the betterment of our people. Now for your handy day.
This message is from the Akinfade Foundation in partnership with the National Orientation Agency with support from MacArthur Foundation.
Welcome back. 360 Nigerians have arrived the country. 306 Nigerians have arrived the country from the United Arab Emirates on Wednesday. The Nigerians and Diaspora Commission, NITCOM, said the returnees arrived at the Nnamdi Azikiwe International Airport at about 8 a.m. on Wednesday morning. It adds that although the evacuees have tested negative to COVID-19, they will undergo mandatory self-isolation in line with guidelines from the Presidential Task Force and Nigeria Center for Disease Control, NCDC. The Ondo State government has sued two secondary schools in the state for violating COVID-19 protocols set by the state government for reopening of schools. Permanent Secretary of the State Ministry of Education, Science and Technology, Akin Asanio, confirmed this in Akure, the state capital. According to him, the schools were closed for not complying with all COVID-19 protocols after the schools were reopened for pupils of the Senior Secondary School 3 in the state. He explained that the pupils of the affected schools were seen roaming the street, clearing bushes, and staying in an unclean environment. The commissioner further stressed that there was no single preparation on the part of the affected schools, and the facility will remain sealed until basic things are put in place. The U.S. government has donated 250 ventilators to Ethiopia to help in its response to the coronavirus pandemic. The donation came after a promise made during a phone conversation between President Donald Trump and Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed in April. U.S. Ambassador Michael Rhino said the donation reinforces its unwavering commitment to the Ethiopian people. The U.S. has also revealed that it would provide warranty and service plans as well as training for Ethiopian medical professionals. Ethiopia has so far confirmed 19,877 COVID-19 cases with 343 deaths and 8,240 recoveries. Zimbabwe's Vice President Constantino Chiwenga has been appointed as health minister about a month after the ministry was rocked by a scandal surrounding the procurement of coronavirus tests and equipment. Chiwenga is a former head of the army who led the military takeover from former President Robert Mugabe. His predecessor at the health ministry, Obadiah Muyo, appeared in court in June over corruption charges related to a $20 million contract award to a Hungary registered firm, allegedly without going through proper processes. Zimbabwe has confirmed nearly 4,200 coronavirus cases, including 81 deaths, but the actual number of cases is thought to be much higher. We'll take a break here to bring you more stories from the world of business, foreign scene, and sports.
On Digi 360, we don't just ask the questions. What is wrong with amending the Constitution the way the National Assembly members have been doing it? We seek answers.
Constitution is constituent.
Our problem is not lack of laws. Our problem is lack of the will power to implement our laws.
Answers that provide clarity.
While we negotiate, we should try to make it a point that the girls must be complete.
The clarity you need to make informed judgment so that you can make the right decision and take action.
People are saying it is you politicians that are responsible for this, that you are the reason why this is happening.
All these dullards that call themselves governors in this country?
I wish we had people like Tony at the National Assembly.
God forbid that I go to join that
Digi 360, providing clarity to issues.
It's about the files your secretary presented to me regarding the company salary. Yes, the figures don't seem to add up. I suspect there's some form of a
discrepancy.
Precisely, sir.
Keep the figure that way. That's for the winter. That's my money.
I'm sorry, sir. I can't do that, sir.
See how padded your teeth are. Are you telling me you cannot pad up figures?
Sir, padding is against best auditing practices, and it's a form of corruption.
It's true. Accountants.
You were testing. Thank you, sir.
That's it. My colleague.
Yes, sir.
You are fired.
Fine.
Yeah.
Fine, sir. Rather than watch corruption grow under my watch, padding is a form of corruption and not in my country, sir. Corruption not in my
country. Stop corruption now.
Welcome back, let's talk business. China is becoming apprehensive about releasing loans to Nigeria following probes by the National Assembly on loans earlier released to the country by the Asian nation. Minister of Transportation Chibuike Amaechi and the Minister of Justice, as well as Attorney General of the Federation Abubakar Malami, said this in a live television program on Tuesday. Both ministers argued that Nigeria's sovereignty was not at risk in the country's loan agreement with China, as recently claimed by the National Assembly. Amaechi said a probe by the National Assembly has made some Chinese to think that Nigeria was probing the loan agreement in order not to repay their about $2 billion so far collected from China. Fulham made an instant return to the Premier League on Tuesday, beating Brentford 2-1 at Wembley. Defender Joe Bryan was the unlikely hero for Scott Parker's side in the Championship playoff final, scoring two goals in extra time after the London clubs were locked at 0-0 at the end of the cagey 90 minutes. The Craven Cottage club will earn around £135 million for bouncing back from relegation last season, and this result also gives rookie boss Parker a first success for his fledgling managerial career. And that's the latest from the newsroom at this time. Many thanks for watching. Bye for now.